Hello, and welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. My name is Nate Carpenter, and today we're going to be looking at building a multi-step form inside of Scriptcase. So this is an example of one that we're going to build here. As you can see, it shows the steps at the top and then has some forms here. So let's just walk through it and see how it works. So I'm going to enter my email, a password, and then I can click Next and it'll go to the next step. Here I can enter some social network items here. You can make these fields anything you want, but this is just an example of one of them. I can go back to the previous step if I want to redo something, and then I can go on. And now this is the final step. We can enter some personal details here. So let me enter some data here. My name, my last name, a dummy phone number, and a dummy address here. Like so. And then all the data is entered. I can go back or I can submit it here. And of course, right now, nothing is done when we submit it, but we'll handle that in Scriptcase. So if we go back here, it updates the tracker up at the top. Now here, we see the HTML for it, and we have some different fields here, and we'll look through how to build this and how to integrate this into Scriptcase. And then we have CSS down here, so this will mostly just be copied right in. So we have different areas for the background, and then the form itself, and then the progress bar up top. And we'll look at how that is built. And then we have JavaScript down here. And we'll look at how to integrate this in Scriptcase, but most of it can be copied right in. So it's very easy. You don't have to know too much about coding, but we'll explain it some. So let's go over to Scriptcase now, and let's do this in a control application. So I clicked New Application here. And now we're in a control application. Let's name it. MS Form, like so, for multi-step form. And then the important part is this item down here at the bottom that you might not have noticed. It's set the HTML template manually. And that will allow us to set the layout manually and control it completely by ourselves instead of Scriptcase doing it. So I check that and click Create here. And here you see that HTML template right here. So we have HTML, then we have CSS, and then JavaScript. And then we can also use an external library, which you might have seen in the login applications in the security module. So there's that, and you might see that there are some markups here. So you've got this field info for the field, got some form attributes, and those are all in the curly braces there. And that tells Scriptcase where it needs to put certain information. So that's HTML markup there. And if you click check right here, it'll make sure that all the pieces are in place for Scriptcase to be able to run that form and validate it correctly. So now let's create some fields. So I go over the field and new field. And we're going to create the same fields that we did over here in this example right here. So if you add them all up, there's about 10 fields in there. So we're going to create 10 fields at once. So let me put 10 in here, just like so, and click Next. So there are our 10 fields, and now we just need to name them. We're not going to worry about labels, because we're going to control the labels ourselves. So we start out with email, pass, and then confirm password. And then the next set of fields is the social network one, so Twitter, Facebook, and then Google+, like so. And then the last set is the personal information. So we have the first name, the last name, then the phone number, and then the address. And there are all our fields. And address is going to be a multi-line text. So there we go. Now we just need to set the length on these. So let's go to email, click on that one. And if you look down here towards the bottom, we have the maximum size. That's set to 20. That needs to be a little bit longer. So we're going to set all these to 60 here. So I'm just going to go through all of these. I'm going to speed it up here a little bit. So confirm password, and now Twitter, just setting them all to 60, like so. First name, last name. Phone, and then lastly address, and that's a multi-line, so I'm going to make that 200, and let's save that now. Okay, so now all of our fields are set up with the correct lengths. Let's go back to user HTML now, and let's start editing the layout here. So if we click check now that we've added all these fields, you can see it's missing all the field info for those fields. So the field info goes right there, and that includes information such as the type of input and the ID as well. So if I take that one there, and I make that email, so SG field email, right there. Now that one is correct and in place like that. So I need to do this for all of them, all the fields here, and include all of them in place. What I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to start with this form over here because I can actually copy all of this. So if I maximize it here, you can see a little bit more. And we see it's broken up in the field sets, and that's each of those three steps on the form. So each step is broken up into a field set. We've got three field sets there, and each of those fields are placed into those. And we're going to use those in the JavaScript to enable us to move between them. So I'm going to copy this, and then all I need to do is put in the field info and the other markup things. So let's copy this entire form. And let's put it right below the existing form here. We're going to eventually get rid of it, but let's go ahead and put it in below there. So there it is. We've got all the fields now that we need. And then we just need to copy all the markup things over into this new form. So let's start here at the top. So the head is already in place. We're going to leave that. We're just going to delete the form. So we need to copy the form attributes. That's going to tell us where it's going to submit to and what type of form it is. So put that in place. And then the field info for email, let's copy that and put that in the field for email right here. There we go. And then lastly, we just need this form hidden comment here. Scriptcase uses that for some of its processing. So we just need to put it in right at the beginning of the form. There we go. And I think that's everything except for the submit button here. Let's put that in place on the submit button of our new form. There we go. So now let's delete our old form here. Don't need it anymore. And I forgot the bracket there. Let's put that back in place. So we've got our different field sets here. Let's go ahead and check this. Okay. So it's almost all done. We missed this class. Scriptcase needs that. And you can click on it. You can see more info here. And we're just going to copy that little bit of code there and put it in place on the email. We just need one of those so that Scriptcase can run the form correctly. There we go. And if we click check again, it'll take that and turn it to blue. There we go. So now we need to do that same thing that we did on the email field for all of those fields. So I'm going to do that real quickly and we'll come back and everything will be in place now that you've seen the process. Okay. So now everything is in place. We've got all the info items here, and if we look down here, we have an optional area that's yellow. And this is the labels for all those fields. And we're not going to do that because we are using placeholders here instead of the actual labels. So we'll control that right inside of the template here. So if you look here, we've got this progress bar area, and that's this progress bar at the top. And that's just an unordered list with line items here, and it's got an active class. We'll see how that works in the CSS. And then we've got field sets, like we saw before, for each step in the form. We've also got a next button on each step, and then a previous button if that's valid. So we've got a previous button on the middle step, and then the last step. And then a submit button on the very last step to actually submit the form. And then two more items here. We're adding the jQuery library, JS library, and then the jQuery easing library too. We're going to use that for some animation. That is going to be important for the JavaScript side of this. So now let's go to CSS here. So I click on that, and that'll enable us to use those classes and everything. So let's go back to our example, and let's go ahead and expand the CSS area. And this can actually be copied verbatim. We don't need to change anything here. So let me just copy it here and paste it in here. And let's talk about it a little bit and explain some important elements here. So we're importing the fonts, the height, and then the background here. That's going to be that gradient on the background, that kind of orange, the purple gradient there, setting some more font families. And then this next area is the actual form itself, that white area, that's the MS form. So it's setting the background, the size of it, the width of it, all that information. And then the field sets, so the white and everything. And then one more item I'm going to talk about is that progress bar. So you have that class right there on the unordered list. And that's going to set kind of the colors of it and control it as it moves around to the different steps so that it turns green and reflects the progress being done in the form itself. So I've got that active class down here too. So there's a lot in this CSS file. You can change some of it to adjust the colors how you might want it. But for now, let's save it. We can leave it as is. And now let's do the JavaScript side of this. So let's go ahead and expand this JavaScript area, and we're going to copy that. So let me select it all and copy it, and we're going to modify it just a little bit. So now I've got a JavaScript on our control application. We can get rid of that code in there, and now let's copy our code in. So the first thing we do is set up some variables for the field sets. So those are each of those field sets here. And then we're going to set up some variables here used for animating the left, the opacity, and the scale. And then we're going to set up a Boolean operator that tells us if we're in the process of animating. Now we need to set up the code for the next button. So we've got two of those on the first field set and the second field set. So this function here controls when that is clicked. First, we check if we're animating. If so, we just get out of there. Otherwise, we set animating to true. Then we get the current field set. So this is the button that they clicked, and we get the parent of that button, which is the current field set. And then we get the next field set using the jQuery next function, which is going to get the next element in the file. Then we're going to get that progress bar with the field set, and basically we're figuring out where we are in the process. And then we're setting active on that next item in the progress bar here. So we're setting that class that's controlled in CSS. So that's that class right there, removing it between the different items in the unordered list. That'll turn it green. Then we're going to show the next field set like that. That's the jQuery function. That'll set the display property. And then we're going to go on to this jQuery animate function here. So that's going to control the opacity there. We can set the opacity to 0. And then we'll be able to set a step here. So you can look at the documentation for this in the jQuery documentation to maybe change this a little bit if you want. But basically, we're going to pass in some variables. Now is the current opacity. And then MX is a tween object in jQuery, which is going to allow us to set some properties of the in-between state of the animation. So we're going to change the scale here. So we set up that we're going to reduce it by 80%. So there's a math equation there to figure that out. And then we're going to move it left by 50%. And then we're going to change the opacity of the next one here. Now we actually write those changes to the CSS here. So the current field set, we're going to transform it with the new scale. So it's going to be smaller. And the position to set that to absolute to make sure it sets up correctly. And then for the next field set, we're moving it over left and changing the opacity. And then we set the duration here of this animation. That's going to be 800 milliseconds. That's a millisecond value. And then when it's all done, we hide the current field set completely and then set animating to false. And then easing is just determining how that easing is going to be done. If you look at the documentation, you can change that to something else. And then all we have to do after that is set the functionality for the previous button, which is going to be much the same as the next button, except we're moving it the other direction. So we're going to be moving it over right. So we change the math formulas a little bit. We increase the size of it instead of decreasing the size and all that. So it's basically the same thing, except it's going the other direction. And then the submit function here, we can get rid of that because we're going to handle that with Scriptcase. And Scriptcase will validate everything for us. So we don't have to worry about doing that ourselves in JavaScript. So now we're going to run this and see if the functionality of moving between the steps works. So here's our first form. Click next on that and it's going to move us to the second step. And then click next on that and it'll move us to the final step. We can move back between them now too. So the previous button works and everything works as expected. So now we just need to set up the submit action of this. So now that everything is in place and the UI works, we're going to go over to events. This is the PHP side, and we need to validate all these fields. Once that is done, we can go to the onValidate success event here. That's after everything is validated. And let's look at the database to see how we're going to insert into that. So we're going to go to database, database builder, choose our connection here, and we're going to go into this clients table here. And this is the structure of our clients table. So this is much like the fields you saw on screen with the name and the email, etc. So let me copy some code in here and I'll explain it. So the first thing we need to do is check if it has already been saved. This is because it might have been executed twice with the multi-step form. We just need to make sure that doesn't happen. And then we have some SQL here to insert into that table with all the values that it got out of the form here. So we're using the curly braces to get those values out, save it in the insert, and then execute that insert query there, and then set the isSaved boolean to true so that we know it's been saved. Let's click save on this, and then all we need to do is set the initial value for that boolean. So we're going to go to the onApplicationInit. This is the first time the application runs, and we set it equal to false, right, like so. So now, everything should work with our UI and the backend of this to actually write the record to our database. So let's go ahead and run this. And we forgot one step. We need to set this to an output variable. So let's go over here and programming, actually application, the blue tap application. Go to global variable. And there is our variable there is saved. And we need to set it to an output variable like so. Let's go ahead and run that. There we go. And let's go ahead and enter some data and see if this works. So I'm going to enter my email here, necarpenter@gmail.com. Enter a password. I'm just going to choose admin as a password. Click next. And let's put in my Twitter username, like so. Click next. And then my first name, Nate, last name, a dummy phone number, and then a dummy address. And click submit. And we don't have any messaging set up for this. This is going to go around to the beginning of the form. But now it is saved. We could set up messaging if we wanted. Let's go back to our table here in the database builder and select the data and see if the record is there. And there it is. There is my password that I entered, my Twitter handle and my last name, my email, all of that. So that all works. And if we went to edit fields here on the control application, we could set some validation here. We could determine which fields are required. We could change the email field to be an email, so it would require a valid email format and all of that. But that is basically how you build a multi-step form inside of Scriptcase using some JavaScript, some HTML, and some CSS. So I hope this was helpful for you, and I'll see you in the next tutorials.